Hello everyone. Did you know dragging an unwanted app to the trash doesn't always remove all its related files from your Mac? These residual files and folders can remain on your SSD or hard disk drive, taking up valuable storage space, slowing down your Mac's performance, and even posing security risks. In this tutorial, I will show you how to fully delete apps from your Mac using a free app uninstaller called Pearcleaner. To fully delete an unwanted application from your Mac's SSD or hard disk drive, first go to macupdate.com. In the search bar, type Pearcleaner. Next, click the application icon. Then click the download button. You may have to wait a few seconds. It will be downloaded to your download folder or desktop. Pearcleaner requires macOS 13 or later. Open the zip file and drag the Pearcleaner icon to your applications folder. After double-clicking its icon, you will see a prompt that reads, Pearcleaner cannot be opened because Apple cannot check it for malicious software. Click OK. Next, click the Apple logo, select System Settings, and click Privacy and Security on the left sidebar. After that, scroll down until you see the Security pane. It reads, Pearcleaner was blocked from the use because it is not from an identified developer. Click Open anyway. Enter your admin password and click Modify Settings. Next, click Open. Pearcleaner displays all the installed applications on the left sidebar, making it easy to decide which one to uninstall from your Mac. Before deleting an app, let's configure its settings. To do this, click Pearcleaner and select Settings. Under the Appearance settings, I turn off the toggle button for transparency. I make sure the toggle button for instant search is on, and I want the application to be in dark mode. You can select Auto or Light. To reduce the size of the application window, turn on the toggle button. I accept the default settings for the applications list and popover window. You will need to grant full disk permission to allow the Pearcleaner app to uninstall an application completely. If you click on the mini folder, you will notice that the toggle button for full disk permission is already on. It is important to keep this toggle button turned on, as it allows you to view files and folders related to the app you want to delete. If the toggle button for the Sentinel monitor is turned on, the Pearcleaner app will launch automatically every time you drag an application to the trash. However, I prefer to turn it off to save over 5 megabytes of memory. It is not necessary to keep it running in the background. Next, click the Update tab and adjust the update frequency to your preference. I am setting it to 7, So the Pearcleaner app will check for updates once a week. Finally, click About for the version number and the developer's contact info. Now that we have customized the settings, let's uninstall an application. To uninstall an app, you need to go through the list of your applications and select the one you want to remove. Before clicking the trash icon, double-check the files and folders list and ensure they all belong to your chosen application. In this case, all files and folders have the same name, disk speed. If you come across a file with a different name or are unsure of its relation to the app, you can deselect it from the list. If you want to deselect all of them, click the square button. If you need to find the location of a file or folder, click the folder icon on the right to see its location. To sort the application files alphabetically, click the ABC button. Click the hash button to sort them by size. To manually drag an application to the Pearcleaner window, click the plus button in the upper right corner and drag an app to the window. Click the clock icon to see files and folders remaining from previously installed applications, so use caution when deleting them. Now that everything looks okay, I'll click the trash icon to delete the app. Next, enter my admin password and click OK. If you have accidentally deleted an app, open the trash, select all the files and folders, press the right button on your mouse, and select Put Back. Next, enter your admin password and click OK to send them back to their original location. I hope you learned something new today. If you did, please consider subscribing by clicking on the LT Lucid Tutorials logo and sharing the video link with your friends. Your support will inspire me to create more videos for you. Thank you for watching.